Let's put the Tinkercad Sketch Revolve to work. We're going to make a track for testing tops. So let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. It is absolutely free. I simply choose sign in with Google. Your homepage looks like this. You'll see your designs, your circuits, and your code blocks. Today we're going to work with 3D designs, so we can simply hit create new 3D design. I am going to name this top track. I'm going to show you real quickly when you build with Tinkercad. Normally you bring out solids. Once you set them down, they are already saved. I'm going to show you what that looks like. If we back up to the Tinkercad dashboard, bang, there is our project. We can simply hit Tinker this to re-enter it. Now, building with blocks and other shapes is a ton of fun. You can just simply stack and make whatever you want. You can take shapes, sink them in, turn them into holes, and then you can do Control G to group. And this is how we have generally always built things. If you want to learn the basic skills, I've got several tutorials in what I call a day one playlist. You can check it out in the cards or with the bit.ly up above. Right now I'm going to delete that though, and I want to show you a brand new tool called Sketch Revolve. When I bring this out, you'll notice that I'm trying to get it right inside a 20 by 20 grid. It's got that dotted center line that lines up perfectly. When you do that, this is all lined up, which makes the rest of the project easier. Now my goal today is to make a track for testing tops that is a 30 centimeter diameter. I am doing that because I want to show how to make parts that are larger than the print bed. So I'm just going to show you real quick. If I move out here 9 centimeters and I just make the tiny track, it's 5 by 10, this would create an 18 centimeter track. So we're just going to go over here to settings, and I'm going to click on the size of our bed, and instead of 200, I'm going to make it 300 by 300. That lets me get to the 30 I want. If I want a little extra space so I can see around it, I can do 400. My printer bed does not go that large though, so it's really kind of silly. Once I click out here, that stretches out. So instead I can just drag this out to 15. Now one thing I can do to make my life a little easier is I can hit P for pen. And I'm going to just draw a fake part up above, and I can just measure that 150 so I know the exact spot to put it. Once I've got that done, I can hit delete, and there is my track. If I hit finish sketch, if I had a printer with a large enough bed, I could simply print that. I do not have a printer that large though, so I'm going to break this up into pieces. Check this out. If I change this to 90 degrees... we have just got the instant section we need. Now I am going to bump up the sides. I'm going to leave the quality like that. Now if you want this inside edge to be rounded, check this out. I can double click to edit, and I'm going to hit number 4 to add a point. And I want to add these at special spots. So I'm going to hit number 1, and I'm going to move in 2 sections. So I want to go right there, and I want to go right there. I'm going to totally get rid of this one right here. Now I'm going to hit V to go back to editing, and I want to click on this line, and I want to auto smooth it. Bingo. It takes that and gives it a nice smooth corner. I'm going to adjust it though. I'm going to shut off these dimensions, and I want it to be the straight corner. I have found that these end up being the nicer radius. I can also click on this, and I can use the arrow keys to nudge it one click each way. That keeps them smooth as you find the perfect rounding that you want. Notice I'm matching these in both, so here I am one click up. I'm going to go back here and choose one click as well as I try and find the exact rounding I want. I don't like that, I do like that, and I am going to go up and I'm going to choose to do this by halves. That way I can get to the exact point. And I do want you to know you can nudge the handles with these as well. See how that turns orange? And bang, that is the radius I want. So you can get really precise with this. When you hit finish, check out how smooth that turned out. I do want to note too that this is only 150 millimeters, so even if you have a smaller printer, it'll still work. So now let's build the snap fit. We're going to do this with the awesome sketch tool. Once again, I'm making sure that that one's lined up. See how it's right on a line? And I just want to put this in a 20 by 20 close to it to make this easier to line up. I'm going to set my nudge to 1 millimeter again. All right, so now we're just going to move over here and build the part super slick. So I'm going to tell you 3 millimeters in, start your lines, and we're going to move up 5 millimeters and then out one. Notice the dimensions show us where we're at. If your dimensions are off, this is how you toggle them. You can also use the shortcut key. This one is 6 millimeters, and then come back once again in one to make the exact match. Down here, 5 out, 1 over, bring it back 6 and connect it. That is our part. You can simply hit finish sketch and that piece is built. Now we do want to make it a hole. We're also going to change the height to 3 millimeters and press enter. Now we need to put this connector at this end as well. We're going to do it like this. Control D, shift nudge to move it over, and we need to rotate it 90 degrees. Now when you click this handle, if you come out this far, it's 1 degree at a time. If you stay close, it's 22 and a half degrees at a time. If you hold down shift, it's 45 degrees to get it lined up perfectly. Now we know we want to put it over here, so let's just move it close. But then let me show you how to line it up exactly. First, I'm going to click that piece and do F for fit view, zoom out a little bit, and then we're going to use the fact that this is a centimeter grid to line it up really quick. So first I'm bringing out a cube, I'm shrinking it down to 10 millimeters. Notice you can also type the 10, and then I'm just going to grab those two and choose L for a line. Make the red one the boss, bingo. This part is now centered. I can line it up exactly by nudging it back 1 millimeter. In this case, we can see that there were 5 millimeters out there. And here's a cool bonus trick. If we double click, they superimpose and you can tell that the zero line was exactly lined up as well. Finish sketch and call that good. I'm going to delete this and we're going to need the actual printed connector when we're finished. So I'm going to do Control D again and shift nudge again. I'm going to make that one a solid, make sure I move it a long ways away, grab these parts, and do Control G to group. This is called a union group. The red lines mean Tinkercad is thinking. It does take a moment because these are complex, but once it finishes, bang, our dovetail is cut in. So now you've got a choice to make. Do you make it this exact size or do you shrink it down a little bit? I have already printed a couple of these and tested them. I highly recommend you do that. Instead of printing this long piece, once again, just make this one 10, press enter, set your height to the same 5 and press enter, and test this process before you print the entire track. If you decide to make this smaller, I'll show you how I would do it. I'm going to simply do Control D, shift nudge to move it over. If I double click on this one, I simply edit it, and I'm going to take this entire side, and I'm going to move it in 0.1. I'm going to take this entire side, and I'm going to move it in 0.1. Notice I missed the middle dot, so I'm going to re-grab them. And then I'm going to take the end. You can click on the line or the dots, move it in a tenth, and take this one and move it in a tenth. Sometimes I've done 2/10. It depends on the filament I'm using and the printer I'm using, but this is how I would modify these so that you can test them out. Once I hit finish sketch, I'm going to do N for note, and I'm going to put V2 and simply add the note that this is 0.1 smaller. And simply adjust that until you find what works best with your printer and your filament. That's the process, friends. Right now, let's send it for 3D printing. I'm going to bring these in as separate parts. If we do export, STL, I'm going to store it in my 3D modeling folder. This was the track part. I'm going to put an A after this so I can keep track of which is which. And then I'm going to select the piece. Once again, I'm doing the full size one. Once again, export. Notice only the selected shape, STL. And instead of typing the whole word connector, I'm going to just put B and trust myself to remember what's going on. Now, of course, we can bounce to Bamboo Lab Studio. I'm going to hit Create New Project. And we can simply hit Add. Of course, I'm going to do Track A. I'm going to only print 2 of these right now. I'm going to right-click and I'm going to do Clone and add 1 more of these. I'm also going to grab the other part. Once again, Add. It was B. I am not going to clone it yet. I'll once again wait until we've tested that. If I do Control A and I do Auto Arrange, let's see how it sets it up. That's okay. I think I'm going to take this one and nudge it a couple clicks over, though. I am going to right-click on them now, and I'm going to change the filament to the PLA Tough I have from Army Army. I am using the bamboo setting for it. Let's see if I can get these by doing Control-A. Set filament, and I want them to be using the Army Army PLA Tough as well. I'm going to stick with 0.2 standard. Let's slice the plate. And check it out, we'll have half our track in about 30 minutes. Let's hit print plate, double check our colors, and send it to the 3D printer. Real quickly, I do want to highlight, this is the Tough filament from Army Army. I have just started testing it, and so far, absolutely thrilled with the results. All right, so here are our sections. Of course, these are turning out absolutely fabulous. Love the stronger filament. Super sturdy. These are our little parts. Of course, they simply snap in just like that. Pretty darn firm. Friction fit. One thing I do want to note here is I'm making sure the side that was printed down is the same. And they simply snap in just like that. And we'll do this one turned this way. You can see it matches nice and easy, just like that. Just because I can show you, I've got a tiny hammer. Bam. And the rest of those, even without the hammer, super slick. Now, of course, this is all about tops that are made with Tinkercad Sketch Revolve. This tutorial will be coming next week. As you can see, they spin really well. And it makes an awesome little battle arena. Tons of room for you to fiddle around and try and create the ultimate top. All right, so let's wrap up quickly. We've got a couple things we learned today. First, we used Sketch Revolve to make an awesome track. And then we found a way to make that track larger than our printer by snapping it together with dovetail connectors. Those little connectors should be useful for any project that you want to make snap together. Since it's only a centimeter wide and 3 millimeters high, there should be a lot of room for you to apply it to all sorts of applications. You can also use that same technique to make it whatever size you want. And of course, don't forget next week there will be a video showing how to make the tops. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, of course, you get early access to videos. Also, a massive shout out to my Patreon group. Love how it's growing. We are almost up to 300 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, share designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.